Hello everyone, happy holidays. I'm Terrence Kernahan, MPP for London North Centre. The holiday times are some of my favourite times of the year. You get to travel around London seeing lights and decorations popping up on people's houses, and people share generously with those who are less fortunate. But this is a year like no other. We're not able to come together as we once did, but I've been so inspired by the strength and resilience of our community. Tonight, I thought we would share a little bit of festive joy in a safe way. We're going to hear from some great bands as well as some community advocates to hear about what they're doing for others this holiday season. So sit back, relax, grab a nice cozy blanket and some hot chocolate, and I hope you enjoy tonight's evening of festivities. First on our agenda this evening is the Barclay Road Brass Works. Take it away! I think I found my new favorite version. I don't know about you, but I'm going to be humming that song in my head for the next month. The holiday times are a great time for family. Some traditions in my family were for my mom and I to go and buy the Christmas tree, and then my brothers and sister and I would decorate. Who am I kidding? My mom would end up decorating it. But also you get a time to gather with friends, whether it's outside building a snowman or going for a skate in Victoria Park. Speaking of friends, who could that be?
Jackie Thompson from Lifespin. Hi, Jackie. It's great to see you.
Hi, Terrence. It's great to see you too. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. You know, Jackie, I was just thinking about you and the great work Lifespin always does this time of year. Do you mind explaining to the viewers at home a little bit about Lifespin and the work that they do around the holidays?
Well, this is the busiest time of year for reaching out to low-income families with children. We have a Christmas sponsorship program, and usually we give the wish list to the sponsors and they go shopping and get something for the children that they had on their wish list from Santa. However, this year with COVID, it's a little different, and we're doing everything online and remotely and delivering everything to the families as well. So we're matching families up with the sponsors, but it's through gift cards and donations of gift cards or food boxes and getting it out to families that way.
Well, it's incredibly important work, and it's amazing that you've been able to do it despite COVID. We know it's just been an unprecedented year. How has COVID impacted the community that you serve this year?
Well, we've had to adjust for a lot of online streaming kind of programs. So the income tax program does over 1,000 income tax returns every year. It's all being done remotely. The garden program in the summertime with the children, it's a free day camp program so the parents can continue to work. usually we have 15 to 20 children in the garden in the backyard, but with COVID, we went to their homes with gardening kits and we had 249 children sign up. So it increased the ability to serve the families by a lot. And Home Depot donated the first 50 gardening kits. So we took the gardening kits out to the families, including shovels and manure and topsoil and seeds, and did Zoom classroom craft activities and outings. And it was very exciting. And it was beautiful to keep the children connected to learning and to learn how to use Zoom classroom so that when school went back in, they had that knowledge as well. And the free store also went online for virtual shopping. So you can go online and fill out your order. So as people start to go out and visit family or go to services, it's Christmas, or apply for jobs and get back to work, they can do an order of clothes online and actually receive new clothing that's been donated to transport truckloads to get those jobs and feel better about themselves. So the free store is also online. So now we're at Christmas and we're doing an amazing amount of work without our wonderful team of volunteers. Usually we have between 20 and 30 volunteers on site for November and December helping with the Christmas program. But because we want to be safe and keep our family safe, we're down to two people doing the administration of the program, and then we'll have volunteer drivers taking it out starting the week of the 14th. So it's very busy here, and you can probably see it in the eyes. A lot of staring at computer screens and trying to keep things organized. And I hear the mail slot going all day with little drops of gift cards coming through the mail slot. So it's happy to do the work. It's just a lot of work.
Most definitely. You know, it's been a difficult year, and it's amazing to see how life's been has pivoted. And I think we all deserve a happy Christmas.
We do. And Terrence, we have a beautiful story to share of one young lady who has a autoimmune disorder, and she was signed up to go for a cruise with her family. And of course, travel is restricted. So instead of going on the cruise with her family through Make-A-Wish, she sponsored 120 children for Christmas. So it's very heartwarming. And if someone can reach out and do that, like, it says a lot about our community and just the willingness to care for each other. And we're so grateful.
Definitely. It's truly, truly beautiful. Well, Jackie, I know how busy you are this time of year, so I won't keep you any longer. Thank you so much to you, your team, your staff, all the volunteers and donors that make life spin and this holiday season so much brighter. Stay safe and happy holidays.
And same to you, Terrence. It was nice talking to you. Goodbye.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm ready for another song. As you can imagine, this year has been very different for musical groups such as choirs. One of my favorites, London's All City Choir, has shared with us one of their favorite songs. Don't be afraid to sing along if you know the words.
Good evening. We're the All City Choir. We're very excited to participate in this special event, celebrating the holidays with our community.
Normally, we would be busy getting ready for our annual holiday concert. However, this year, due to COVID-19 restrictions, we were unable to sing together in person.
Although it hasn't been easy, we continue to rehearse virtually and share our love of singing together every Monday night.
Under the direction of Michelle Reese and accompanied by David Beaudoin, we are thrilled to share this previously recorded selection from our holiday concert last year.
We look forward to singing for you again in person in the very near future. Until then, stay safe, take care of one another, and from all of us at All City Choir,
happy holidays!
Christmas tree and the way the lights will stand.
That was awesome. Thank you, All City Choir. Speaking of choirs, I'm joined by Dr. Carol Bynan, Artistic Director of the Immobile Choirs of London, Canada. Hi, Carol. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, well, thanks for having us. We're really pleased to be here.
Well, can you tell us a bit about what Immobile has been up to and what you'll be sharing with us this evening?
Sure. Well, the Immobile Choirs of London, Canada, we're actually made up of 8 choirs and several hundred singers and 10 conductors. So I'm just one of the conductors that is here for tonight. And we put together a Christmas concert. We did an in remembrance show, and now we've put together a Christmas piece. And as you can imagine, it's been really difficult because you can't sing during COVID times. And we've been working from home on Zoom with children. And our singers go from age 8 to 78. We've been working with children who've never sung in a choir before and still can't hear a choir because when you're on Zoom, you can't hear anybody else except yourself. So it's been quite a challenge and quite unique, but we've put a concert together at any rate. And the song that we've chosen for you to do today is from our youngest girls, our Da Capo Immobile Choir and our Junior Immobile Singers. And they've put together a holiday medley with, I'll Be Home for Christmas and Silver Bells and Let It Snow. And they've put it together all individually in their own homes. And then we've had a technician put the tapes all together. So that's what you're going to hear today.
You know, my niece is an actor with Original Kids, and they had to do the same thing. All the children had to act independently of one another. Completely by themselves, and it's truly fascinating what we can do with technology.
It's not the same as singing together, and we can hardly wait to get back together. Our other choir is taped with cars at a drive-in choir. We came into Westmount Mall in their lower parking lot and had cables and microphones out to all of them, and they could hear each other through the radio. So that was kind of exciting too. But this group has done it all online individually, with parents helping beside them and so on, because they're range in age from 8 to 10 years old.
Oh, that's fantastic. Well, again, Carol, thank you so much for joining us. Let's check out the clip.
Thank you. Happy holidays, everyone. And I hope that no matter what traditions you choose to celebrate, you're finding a way to make the most of what's been a crazy year. And my name is Mark Payne, and I am part of a collective of musicians from London, Ontario called True North Music. Now, we're mostly theater performers who found ourselves out of work when COVID hit. So, to connect with our audiences and stay sane, we decided to start a series of online concerts just to keep connected. The latest initiative we just finished was called The 12 Songs of Christmas, where we presented a different Christmas video every day for 12 days. Now, this is one of the tunes from that show, and even though the show is over, if you want to check out all the songs, you can at True North Music on YouTube. Just search us up. In the meantime, enjoy this classic Christmas song made famous by Chuck Berry called Run Rudolph Run.
One, two, one, two, three, four. Mine. Run, run, Rudolph, Randolph ain't too far behind. Run, run, Rudolph, Santa's gotta make it to town.
Run, Rudolph, run, Rudolph.
Santa, make him hurry, tell him he can take the freeway down.
Run, Rudolph, run, Rudolph.
Run, run, Rudolph, I'm reeling like a merry-go-round. Six Santa to a boy child, what have you been longing for? All I want for Christmas is a rock and roll electric guitar. And then away went Rudolph, shooting like a shooting star. Oh, run, run, Rudolph, Santa's gotta make it to town.
Run, Rudolph, run, run, Rudolph.
Santa, make him hurry, tell him he can take the freeway down. What would please you most to get? I want a little baby dolly that can cry, sleep, drink, and wet. And then away went Rudolph, shooting like a saber jet, gang, gang. Run, run, Rudolph, Santa's gotta make it to town.
Run, Rudolph, run, run, Rudolph.
Santa, make him hurry, tell him he can take the freeway down. Let's go!
was really fun. During the holiday seasons, it's so important to think of others. This year has been particularly hard on so many families, and it's been a struggle for the organizations who serve them. I'm so grateful tonight to be joined by Deacon John Thompson of St. John the Evangelist Anglican Church in Old North. Hello, Deacon. How are you?
I'm just fine. Thank you. Yeah.
Thanks so much for joining us tonight. Can you tell us a bit more about the Saturday Night Meal program, and how long has it been going on?
It actually started 22 years ago. It started off as a soup kitchen, a soup and sandwich, but that evolved really quickly into a sit-down hot meal every Saturday night. And it's been doing it ever since. Ups and downs, and we're having a down right now. But a down in terms of the current situation has changed things dramatically, yeah.
Absolutely. You know, well, how has it changed because of COVID? How have you adapted your program?
Yeah, well, the usual pattern is that we have sit down starting at 5 o'clock, and people are pretty much gone by six. In that hour, we normally feed anywhere between 100 and 130 people. It's a bit of a rush. With COVID, we have gone to two seatings and takeout. The first couple of months were takeout only. Starting in September, we switched to 30 people sitting down at 3 o'clock and another 30 people sitting down at 4:15. And I gather with the red zone coming along this weekend or next week, we're going to have to go back to takeout. It's changed in terms of how we do it, takeout and dine in. It's also changed in terms of the hospitality nature of things. A lot of our guests would come because they knew that their friends were coming, and it would be a very much a social event. It's pretty hard to have a huge social event if you're sitting at one end of a 6 foot long table, so staring at somebody else. But it's warm, and you don't have to line up. It's all table service. And tomorrow, we're going to have three seatings actually. We have our annual Christmas dinner, and. A group of faithful people from a parish out in the country, St. George's on 13 Mile Road, are going to come and they're going to serve that meal, and they're bringing in a gift bag for all of our guests. And we're probably going to have at least 130, maybe 150 people in the course of that time. Well, usually we approach 200 at Christmas time because it's a great meal. The numbers dropped down initially with the pandemic, but they're creeping back up now and they're almost back to normal. Although they're pretty much evenly split between takeout and dine in now. Yeah.
Understood. Well, you know, it's tremendous work that you do for the community. Yeah. I did want to ask, what support do you need from Londoners, and how can viewers help out St. John the Evangelist in the Saturday Night Meal program?
We fund this primarily through our annual 5K walk and run. You and your team won a prize this year with your virtual walk. and we normally raise about $12,000 to $14,000. It costs us about $20,000 to run a year. But this year, with the pandemic, Londoners are really generous, and And we raised twice what we expected we were going to raise. We had $24,000 in the bank now. So money we don't need. If people would like to experience what goes on, we have, they could call the church and get stuck on our volunteer list. And from time to time, very often, each Saturday night, we may need one or two volunteers to fill in the teams that we already have. I think the best way you could help out right now is to look to the people who are homeless in town here. I know that the London Food Bank is supporting meals being delivered to those people who are camping by the side of the river. I think dollars to the food bank instead of Christmas presents for Aunt Nellie would be a really good thing this Christmas.
That is excellent advice, John. Well, you know, thank you for everything that you do. Thank you for helping the community and doing wonderful things. I really appreciate you joining us this evening. And so, wish you a very Merry Christmas, sir.
A pleasure. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
You know, before I was elected as your MPP, I was a teacher and teacher librarian. One of my favorite things all year was attending holiday concerts where students would sing and perform their favorite songs. We won't be able to do that the same way this year, but Mrs. Sanford's class from Masonville Public School is bringing the concert to us. Let's hear what they have in store for us.
Good evening. We are grade 4 students from Masonville Public School. We're going to perform We Wish You a Merry Christmas on handbells. Happy Holidays.
Great. Thank you, Ms. Sanford, and your talented music students. Well, if there's one thing librarians have a lot of, it's books. There are so many great classic holiday stories to choose from. Tonight I'll be reading for you The Night Before Christmas. It's one of my all-time favorites. I picked up my copy at the London Public Library. "'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below, when what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer, now Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all! As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky. So up to the housetop his coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof, the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his sack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings. He turned with a jerk, and laying his finger on the side of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." Good night, everyone.